Well, it stumbles and it falls off of almost every tongue. You will listen and you will hear. It's lurking like a landmine and almost every sentence is an assault to my mind's ear. Yeah, it might have started back with Jack Kerouac. Probably more than likely it was made of G-Cribs. It's the four-letter word that used to mean as if, and the meaning's covered in cobwebs. Cobwebs. Used to be a preposition, then it was a conjunction. Now it's used as an audible pause. Oh, I hate it when I hear it, especially when I say it. Got to stamp it out, there ought to be some laws. College boys, valley girls, mall rats, grandmamas, everybody's misusing that word. I heard it four times in one poor little sentence. It was the saddest sound I ever have heard. Cobwebs. Cobwebs. I suppose you could blame it on my generation. Chickens from the 60s finally coming into roost. I've been saying it myself for over 30 years now, just to give my cool quota just a little bit of kind of a boost. But when I hear it, I can't stand it, especially coming out of the mouths of one of my own kids. It's been taught and God, what have we wrought? Give a listen here what we did. I prefer our, you can rest assured. If you stand what you mean, then it don't mean a thing. It's just another little four-letter word. Doesn't anybody care, or am I the only one? Am I just stuck back in some kind of a past? Maybe it's harmless, but it feels like a virus. It sounds like it's catching on fast. Cobwebs. Cobwebs. Well, it stumbles and it falls off of almost every tongue. Give a listen and you will hear. It's lurking like a landmine and almost every sentence is an assault to my mind's ear. Yeah, it might have started back with Jack Kerouac. Probably more than likely it was made of G-Cribs. It's a four-letter word that used to mean as if, and the meaning's covered in cobwebs. Cobwebs. Doesn't mean a thing. Cobwebs. Little bitty boost. Jack Kerouac. Cobwebs. Maynard G. Cribbs.